Welcome to a second video on integration involving inverse trigonometric functions. Since we already discussed these in the last video, let's go and take a look at a couple more examples. The examples in this video, they're not going to be obvious as to which formula is going to apply. For example, on this first problem, we might be thinking the formula involving arcsine, since there's nothing outside the square root. But notice here we have the constant squared minus the x part squared, but we have the x part squared minus the constant squared. So we're not going to select our formula just quite yet. We're going to go ahead and perform the same routine by rewriting this as something squared minus something squared. Meaning we can rewrite this as e to the x raised to the second power would be e to the 2x. And of course, 1 squared would be equal to 1. Again, without selecting the formula just quite yet, we probably recognize that a has to equal 1 and u has to equal e to the x. Well, the next thing we would do is find differential u. Well, du will equal e to the x dx. But notice we don't have an e to the x dx as part of our integral. We just have dx. Let's go ahead and divide by e to the x. So this tells us that dx is equal to du divided by e to the x. But remember, e to the x is just equal to u. So that's going to come in handy in the next step. Let's go ahead and try to rewrite this in terms of a's and u's. Let's go ahead and start with the denominator. E to the x squared would be u squared, and 1 squared would be a squared. But dx is equal to du divided by e to the x. So if we put the du here, we should put an e to the x here. But remember, e to the x is equal to u, so we can replace e to the x with u. And now we can see that it doesn't fit the formula involving arcsine, but it does fit the formula involving arcsecant. So this will be equal to 1 over a, or 1 over 1, that's just 1, times arcsecant of u over a, which would be e to the x over 1, which is just e to the x, plus c. Let's go ahead and take a look at another one that's not quite so obvious. Again, what's different about this one is that we have this binomial x minus 3 in the numerator. Again, it does not seem to fit the pattern of any of these. So we might be thinking we could just perform basic u substitution, but if we let u equal 4 minus 9x squared, du is going to be negative 18x dx, which again does not fit the numerator. So what we can do, though, is break this up into two different integrals, where we'd have x divided by 4 minus 9x squared dx minus 3 divided by the square root of 4 minus 9x squared dx. Now if we take a look at the first integral, we let this equal u, which is degree 2, du will be degree 1, which will match the numerator. So let's go ahead and try that. So du is equal to negative 18x dx. Notice our integral does have x dx. Let's go ahead and divide by negative 18. So we have negative 1 18th du does equal dx. So while we're here, let's go ahead and rewrite this in terms of u. Again, x dx is equal to negative 1 18th du. And then this is equal to u, so we have 1 over the square root of u, which is equal to u to the negative 1 half power. Now let's see what we can do with this second integral. This one does appear to fit the formula involving arcsine. So let's go ahead and see if we can identify the values of a and u. If a squared equals 4, then a equals 2. And if u squared equals 9x squared, u would equal 3x. So du would equal 3dx. And that's good news because we do have a 3dx as part of our integral. So let's go ahead and rewrite this in terms of a and u and see if it fits this pattern exactly. So 3dx is equal to du. And if a is equal to 2, we would have a squared. And if u is equal to 3x, we would have u squared. So now we can find both of these antiderivatives. For the first one, we'd have negative 1/18 times u to the 1/2 divided by 1/2. Well, u is equal to 4 minus 9x squared. And then dividing by 1/2 is the same as multiplying by 2. And for the second integral, we're going to have arc sine u over a, which will be arc sine 3x divided by 2. Plus c. Let's go ahead and clean this up one more time. We'll have negative 1/9 square root of 4 minus 9x squared minus arc sine 3x divided by 2 and plus c. Okay, well, these were obviously a little more challenging in the first video. In the next video, we'll take a look at completing the square to make our integrands fit one of these three patterns. I hope you found this video helpful.